Psalm 148, 148. And it starts with three words which should bring joy to all our hearts. It says, praise the Lord.
Amen.
Should we try that again? Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
You know, some people even smile. Try again. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise Him in the heights above. Praise Him, all His angels. Praise Him, all the heavenly hosts. Praise Him, sun, moon. Praise Him, all you shining stars. Praise Him, you highest heavens and you waters above these skies. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for at His command they were created. And He established them forever and ever. He issued a decree that will never pass away. Praise the Lord from the earth. You great sea creatures and all ocean depths, lightning, hail, snow, clouds, stormy winds that do His bidding, you mountains and all hills, fruit trees and all cedars, wild animals, wild animals, small creatures and flying birds, kings of the earth and all nations, you princes and all rulers of earth, young men and women, old men and children, let them praise the name of the Lord, for His name alone is exalted. His splendor is above the earth and the heavens. And He has raised up for His people a horn, the praise of all His faithful servants of Israel, the people close to His heart. And how does it end? As it began, praise the Lord. Amen.
And some of those musical items you will hear and you will be a part of.
a bit later on. But what we wanted to start with this afternoon was a quick look back over the past 6.5 years from when Major Barrie Maria first took over leadership of our corps, so we can recognise how we have developed and we can look back and see clearly how God has been faithful to us as a church over these years. Okay, so that's what we're going to do. Are you comfortable? They asked me what, whether they should be worried earlier on. And I couldn't give them an answer. I remember that we as a corps were quite shocked to learn the news of your appointment to Letchworth, simply because you were the first set of officers we were welcoming who were arriving under the age of 60. Just. And you probably would leave us without retiring, and particularly for me in my generation, this was a new experience. So for then, Captains Barrie and Maria Sampson arrived in the summer, from what I remember, in the middle of an interesting time. And those of you who were here may remember that we had the building of our brand new community hall taking place, and we were left with 3/4 of a worship hall. And those of you who remember, we had this great big curtain suitable for a crematorium right at the back of that corner. What were behind those curtains? I do not know. But it was an interesting and an unsettling time. There was dust on the mercy seat. We were dirty. We were untidy. We were cramped. We were somewhat unorganized. Dare I say, a bit smelly. And it's only looking back on this time now we've got to know you, Barrie Maria, how perhaps internally distressed you were with this, as we know how much you like tidy, organized, clean. So we commend you for surviving through that slightly disruptive period. So we therefore understand the feeling of relief you must have felt with that great big hall cleanup. Who remembers that? Where everybody in the corps came in, we had the scaffolding up, we had the long wipers in, and we were preparing to make this a tidy place. So I think that was in preparation for Jackie and Nick's wedding, the first of a quick succession of weddings. So within 1 year we had survived a farewell to a set of officers, a squeeze into one hall, a knocking down of a library hall, a long period of no officers. You remember Keith and Jill Manning left in February and Maria and Barrie did not arrive until the summer. We had the building project going up of a new community hall, and then the welcome of Maria and Barrie Sampson. This was the year 2009. What a year. So if we fast forward to 2012, we think about the Olympic year, where we were fortunate to have a torch come past our hall during our Sunday morning service. So being the Salvation Army, we took the meeting outside to ensure we were not missing out on an important evangelistic opportunity. But those of you who were there may remember it was raining a little bit. And as I'm on the platform, I shouldn't tell a lie, actually it did not stop raining, and it poured and poured and poured. And we had umbrellas up, we had raincoats on, music was getting wet. And I remember actually playing the electronic keyboard under this gazebo. It had a leak. And I questioned this, and I said to the leaders, is this safe? Should I be doing this? And I was told to stop moaning and get on with it. This may have ended in disaster, and then you would have been sorry, but it did not. Hallelujah. So, just like Noah's determination in the Bible to build his ark, to follow God's plan, despite many stating he should not bother, so did we stand outside in the pouring rain to share the message of Jesus to all those standing on the road, despite it being cold and wet, ready for that flame to be run past. And this was the start of regular outside meetings which have started to take place here. A new idea, a bit weird, but one which I hope will carry on. Some would say there's nothing better to praise God whilst catching a nice tan. And a successful idea, which was a risk, but has been paid off, I think. And then we'll turn to 2013, our centenary year, a highlight year for me in terms of my Christian faith. We had the different creative ideas taking place. We had the flower festivals, we had visiting bands, we had the reunion weekend, we had the core meal at the golf club, yes please, to another one of those, and the visit of retired General Shaw Clifton. And I remember from the reunion weekend, many from the older generation were talking about a meeting which they remember taking place in this hall when they were young, and talk about how they had a visiting band, and this meeting, an evening meeting, went on very, very late because so many people were kneeling at our place of prayer, at our mercy seat. But I don't know about you, but I will never forget the morning that this mercy seat was being knelt at by at least half of our Sunday morning congregation on the visit of General Stolperson. I will never forget it. And after a time of prayer, it ended up with various core members standing, surrounding Barrie and Maria, as you were here again. Again, the morning, I'd never forget. Special moments. We've had the start of Messy Church in the past, in these past 6 years, a transformed Sunday school, which is seamlessly developed into another part of our core programme. A new structure to our Sundays, where we now only meet twice on a Sunday for special events, making Sunday mornings have a greater significance and importance in our spiritual lives. We've joined together with Stevenage again. Hallelujah, amen, that's it. And we're excited that we're now moving forward together with officers who are appointed to lead us forward as a unit instead of separate churches. I'm happy about that. I don't know how Stevenage feel, but we're happy to have you. You're happy to have us. If I was to refer to God's faithfulness over the past 7 years, there's no better example to show than reflecting on the children's ministries here, when we were almost non-existent. And I can think of numerous evenings where my mother came home on a Friday night quite distressed, when no children were turning up to Jam Club on a Friday evening. And there's a few pictures where the Messy Church was involving, I think, just Paris. Carol's was there, and she's been faithful all the way through this. And so after a pray like Hannah scheme, where the court were asked to pray for children in the same way Hannah did, we have the Jam Club on a Friday night that's growing rapidly alongside our Messy Church. And those of you who follow Facebook will see how that growth has happened over time. And the point of this section, this part of the meeting, is to prove and highlight God's faithfulness to each one of us through times of transition. Over the last 7 years, we have gone through huge transition. We feel different. We perhaps feel a bit fresh and ready to step out into the future. We are here this afternoon to think about our leadership, and we say thank you to Barrie and Maria for guiding us through this transitional time. And more will be said to you throughout this afternoon. But what we can say now is that we are ready. We are ready to step out into the future. Of course, not knowing what the future holds, but at least we know who holds the future. So as mentioned, we wanted to make this time special for you, Barrie and Maria, to say thank you. And although I included most musical items which you have requested, I took note that over the years you have repeatedly suggested the songsters to sing a song which we've never learned here. And you've requested it numerous times, and we've just never got round to learning it. So as you're leaving, I thought it would be good to encourage the songster leader to make the effort. So the songsters are going to sing this song, which the majors have requested since 2009, God and God Alone. And then you're going to have another song which works well as a reflection of God's faithfulness over the 7 years, to the glory and praise of God. So I hope you enjoy these two songs from the songs.
Take the joy of
in the beginning was the Word. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is why the last 7 years have been so special to me. Quality leadership has shown through. Because, Maria and Barrie, you have obviously put the Word of God foremost in your thinking, in your ministry, in fact, in all things. You obviously consulted the Word and you acted accordingly. Thank you then so much for vital ministry in the small group situation and in Sunday worship, in fact, at all times. I sense also that you have taken to heart the advice of Paul when he speaks to the church at Ephesus, chapter 6, verse 18. Pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying. Again, you have obviously headed up your ministry with prayer, the launch pad of your ministry. A prayer then from the songbook, tailor-made, I believe, for both of you. 756 in the New Salvation Army songbook says, to me and to you, he walks with God, who speaks to God in prayer, and daily brings to him his daily care. Prayer possessing inward peace, he truly knows heart's refreshment and the soul's repose. He walks with God, who as he onward moves, follows the footsteps of the Lord he loves, and keeping him forever in his view, his safety seeds, and his example too. So Maria and Barrie, please rest in him these next 3 months. And then, as I have just read, verse 2, line 2, follow in the footsteps of the Lord, you so obviously love. Into the depths of Yorkshire in July, God bless your heart today. And thank you for 7 fruitful years. Amen.
That's not always easy, especially when you have no leader. It is easy to lose your way, your purpose, and your focus. Barrie and Maria helped us to refocus and our lovers grow, not just for each other, but also by uniting us with everyone here at Letchworth too. And we are so thankful that you make us feel so welcome and loved when we visit you each month. Goodbyes are never easy and can be a challenge, but we're in a good place now to be able to face these things, and we very much look forward to Anne and Steve looking after us over the next couple of months, and then to welcoming our new joint officers in July too. Maria and Barrie wish you every happiness in your new venture, in a very different kind of military environment. I'm sure you'll both do a sterling job, and I'm sure Barrie can teach the military a thing or two about cleaning shoes. I don't know if you've noticed, but Barrie must have the most highly polished army shoes I've ever seen. Maria, I'm sure you will not put army finances into shape as you have done ours at Stevenage, and I promise I will try and remember to read them into us and keep the book regular. Thank you for all you have done for us. You were there in our hour of need, and you have uplifted us and given us the resources and confidence to carry on our work in Stevenage. And I'll finish with two verses from Romans and a verse from the song. Yet in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present nor things to come, nor height nor depth, nor any other created thing, shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. And finally, the verse of the song from John Gowans is the last verse. It's one of my favourite songs, I have to confess. All of our future I cannot see, but promise your presence travel with me. Sunshine or shadows I cannot tell, but you know I love you and all will be well.
Thank you. wonder if you could say a few words of gratitude to Barrie and Maria. Barrie and Maria, as has been hinted, have introduced us to a number of new ways of working, and also introduced us to a number of new concepts. One of the concepts that I was completely unfamiliar with before Barrie and Maria came along, actually, was the concept of glamorous camping or glamping. Now, actually, Barrie, that's a picture of Barrie there. Barrie has a very proud history of outdoor activity. Okay, it's a bit younger than you, but it passes you for now. But Barrie's got a very proud history of outdoor adventure. This is a man who has walked the West Highland Way twice. He's a man who's been in Snowdonia with a number of us, and we can say he's actually a really fit man for his age. He's a man who's done serious camping. But Barrie tried to convince Maria that she should also do the rough stuff and camp. He's chuckling because he knows it's true. He attempted to persuade Maria that she should dine on freshly picked nettle tea and bathe in mountain streams. But Maria was having none of it. Next slide, please. And Barrie was going to smile and despond. He was distraught. What should they do for future holidays? And then he had an idea. Next slide. He just obtained a new chariot, a purpose-built chariot for outdoor activity. Although this picture is actually completely unrepresentative of the Sampson's chariot when it prepares to go on holiday. It is piled to the gunwales with the finest woven Wilton carpets for camping. It calls a diesel generator to provide all the refrigeration, air conditioning and jacuzzi needs. This is true. This is really high-end glamping. If you don't believe me, they have agreed today, as they prepare to depart, to allow you a brief glimpse into their private holiday life by showing you some images from the inside of their tent. Next slide. Pretty much choice. That's good. What about bedroom? Next slide. Fantastic. I think they're taking the four posts down for this occasion, don't they? Really, really impressive that this new clamping. I had no idea about clamping until they came along. And so, in tribute to your history of clamping, Barrie, I've got something for you. Next slide, please. To take you back to the old days, a few things there. Now, I know that for Maria that is no good whatsoever. She expects the highlights. So, Maria, I'm afraid I don't have a gift for you here today. But coming in the post shortly will be. Four Freemasons hampers, which you're acquainted with now, so you should be able to enjoy that. No, clamping, a new concept. But seriously, others have spoken of elements of Barrie and Maria's work. And I would like to speak about one important message that they have given us that we must not forget, even after they're gone. Simply, it's to look out. Not look in, but to look out. It's part of the character of organisations involving people that they become self-regarding. They forget the reasons for their establishment. It's part of our human condition, isn't it? First of selfishness. You may recognise this in the organisations you work in, the schools, the commercial practices, and yes, the hospitals. They become self-regarded. It's a special problem in organisations that have been historically well-regarded. They can become complacent and believe that what they did yesterday will suffice for today. It's a comforting illusion. Sometimes the process is so gradual that organisations do not realise that they're doing it. In fact, so gradual that the very good people in those organisations would be appalled if they realised what's happened. This can easily happen in churches. Barrie's last message this morning, and I hope you remember at least a bit of it. If you've got most of it, excuse me, that's probably okay. But just remember the four words that you finished with. Go and tell someone. Go and tell someone. Introspection in the church and in the Salvation Army is profoundly unscriptural. Can we have up Matthew 28, verse 19, please? The Great Commission. Let's read it out together, shall we, so that we're not deluded. Let's read it out together.
Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
And a little later on, it makes clear that's not a request, that is a command. During their time here, Barrie and Maria have reminded us that Salvation Army was established for the benefits of non-members. In fact, for the benefits of those who could not be accepted anyway. We are absolutely thrilled to have new members here who we did not know a few years ago, a few months ago, even a few weeks ago. As Barrie and Maria move on, let's remember to nurture each other in the responsibility that we are commanded to undertake. We are delighted to be an integral part of a Christian church in Letchworth. Wasn't Good Friday fantastic? Wasn't it fantastic? I remember when there used to be 20 or 30 of us and we'd be shouted at from the pub. There must have been, what, 300? I don't think anybody could have been in Letchworth on Good Friday and not have heard and had a reaction to the Christian gospel. We've been taught to look out more by people who are known in their community. Look around you. They're known in their community. We must not forget that lesson. Now, in the Salvation Army, we're not allowed to give gifts to our officers. In fact, there's some interesting local history in Norton Parish Church. You can see the grave of the family of Gypsy Smith, a very, very famous Salvation Army preacher. That was until he accepted the gift of the gold watch many, many years ago. So we're not, I'm afraid, able to give you gold watches today. But can I say, on behalf of all of us, thank you for all that you have done. We will seek to maintain the flame, to look out, and to make disciples of all. Our good wishes go for the future. Can you join me in standing and thanking Barrie and Maria?
7 years has come and gone very, very quickly. And I just want to say thank you, really, for us all being a family together. And in our immediate family, lots of things have happened in the past 7 years. We'd only been here a few months, a very, very few months, when my mum passed away. And everybody was just so supportive and so kind and blessed us greatly. And that really was, you know, that made us feel that we belonged and that we were a part of this corps and a part of this family. Throughout our time here, we've had some lovely family events. Becky and Rob, who were here this afternoon, got married. And in the same year, Paul and Sadie told us that they were expecting a baby, which was quite a surprise. But, you know, he rang up and he said, "How do you feel about being grandparents?" And we said, "How do you feel about being a father?" But, so Harley came along, and then not too much later, Sebby came along, and Sebby's here with us this afternoon. And then Paul and Sadie got married. So all these momentous family events for us have happened while we've been here. Those of you that were in the meeting this morning heard Barrie ask for prayer for the family that Paul went to as a police officer, that Paul went to on Friday evening, who tragically lost their baby. And I just want to tell you that this morning, and not in the course of her duties, but while she was getting her breakfast in McDonald's, Sadie, Paul's wife, delivered a baby. She popped in for her egg McMuffin, or whatever you get for breakfast in McDonald's, and while they were there, her and her partner in the ambulance came across somebody who needed a little bit of assistance, and a baby was born at McDonald's. I guess in Southend somewhere this morning. And then in 2014, I've just gone back a little bit, 2014, after quite a bit of encouragement from Barrie and our children, I found my birth mother. And so this is another momentous thing that's happened while we've been here. And on the 11th of June 2014, on my 56th birthday, I met Liz for the first time. And that then meant I got three new sisters. And so we don't meet often, but we are in touch. And they have become a part of our family. And so I just want to say thank you so much for allowing us to be a part of this family. We have loved being here. We have loved being part of the Stevenage and the Letchworth cause. We have loved every moment of our service, and we are sad to leave, but we are excited about what God has in store for us in the future. So God bless you all, and we'll just ignore Stephen. He can just do his own thing and entertain us as Barrie has his word.
I'll try not to speak too long because we want you to cake, don't we? So 7 years. Taylor. 7 years has come and gone. A lot of water has gone under the bridge in that time. Robert alluded earlier to transition, and at councils last year in September, October, when we met, were greeted by a territorial commander, and he said to us, "Where are you from?" So we said, "We're from Letchworth." I remember you've been in transition a long time, 6 years, maybe 7 years in transition is a long time. And he said, "You haven't got a chest big enough for the men with you." So we stayed with him, and here we are. We are a very different core from what we came to 7 years ago. We have a less intrinsic outlook than we did 7 years ago. We are more outward focused now, a lot more outward focused. And may that continue. I want to express my thanks to David for the sections and Ali for the sections, the way in which you've responded to our ministry. The way you know that sometimes when we send a meeting plan out halfway through the week,
there's a choice of songs that the Sampsons will sing, or at least that the band will play, how well that piece of music that's either been sung or played has sunk in the structure of the meeting, and how God has used that playing, that singing, within the ministry in Letchworth. We have enjoyed our time here. It's been a fantastic learning ground for us. Because when we came here, you were a very structured core, and everywhere else we've been, we hadn't had that structure. We appreciated in the early days the advice and sometimes the controls that were put in place for us as we tried to lead you on in ministry here. Yes, we have seen a completed community building that now has a fairly substantial community program offering it, operating through it. There are more people coming through this centre here in the course of a week now than we've ever seen before. Many people coming in under your influences as you lead different groups, under the influences of just literature that's around the place. The literature table in the front gets visited on a regular basis, people taking away stuff to read for themselves. And that can only spread the gospel through this. So as we leave here, we leave with heavy hearts, because we leave at quite a crucial time, we believe, in the life of the court. But we did promise you when we came here that we hadn't come here to retire. And it would have been very easy for us just to drop water for a few more years, done one last appointment and then retire. But that wouldn't have been fair on you as a court. Yes, we were asked for, we know, for annual appointment. And we have regretted, in many senses, accepting that appointment because of the time that we are here. But we know it's God's timing. We know the time is right for change, substantial change. And as we leave here, as we bring two more together, Stephen and Jen Letchworth, that will be for the common good of this area, I'm sure. And we will pray continually God's blessings upon you as you seek to minister His name in both locations. Please, don't let that focus drift back to an inward focus. It's there, it's established. You need to be out there. The core of people here will look after each other. Pastorally, we are sound. But there are thousands and thousands of people out there who still need to hear the message. And that's our commission. That is our commission, Matthew 28:19, to go and tell. We would pray God's blessing upon each and every one of you. Those who have gathered this afternoon, who don't normally go to a place of worship. Brian, Sophie, it's so lovely to see you today. Trish, thank you so much for coming. And we do look forward to meeting up with you and Colin before we go. But please take Colin their best wishes and wish him well for us. And others here this afternoon, thank you so much for coming out and making this afternoon very, very special for us. We will never forget it. We will never forget you, we'll be assured. Pray God's continued blessings upon all the good work here in Letchworth. Thank you so much.
It is a real privilege to be here this afternoon representing the Lister Hospital, but it speaks of your outward looking that we have such good relationships, your ability to work across barriers, to build those relationships, and to make things work for the best for those you serve. At the hospital, we've always been thrilled with the way we work together and appreciated your support. So I just want to add our thanks to all the others that have gone before. Barrie and Maria are leaving Letchworth in order to take responsibility for the work of the Salvation Army at Catterick Garrison in North Yorkshire. Far away from family. Catterick Garrison is the British Army's largest training establishment with 13,000 personnel located there. It's the HQ of the 4th Infantry Brigade and the centre for all Phase 1 and Phase 2 training for every British infantry soldier. Salvation Army has a long and proud tradition of providing pastoral support to the British military. My own father served in Burma during the war. And the only people out there with the Salvation Army and Vera Lynn. But he never forgot. At Catterick, this pastoral support is provided from the Vicarage Club at Venus Barracks. young men and women recruits, some as young as 16, from diverse backgrounds and with different abilities, have some of the most challenging experiences of their lives, and many have in recent years gone from there to serve in hostile and dangerous environments. In few situations is the work of the Salvation Army more essential, and in few situations will your sense of family be more needed. During this part of our service, we want to support Barrie and Maria as they prepare for this transition to their new roles and environment. In a moment, as the band plays the hymn to Melita, past and current servicemen of this church will prepare the drumhead altar with a cross and a Bible, a gift from the chaplain of Her Majesty's Royal Naval College Guard. After which, Pastor Michael will invite Barrie and Maria to kneel at the drumhead as they're surrounded by the ministers and pastors of our local churches who will lead us in prayer.
And Lord, I ask that the see why you have placed them there and your great plans for them. But we thank you for them, and we thank you that they are servants for the kingdom. And may they see many people come to know you as Lord and Savior through their ministry. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Father God, we pray that Barrie and Maria's new home will be a place of great love and friendship and peace, and that it will be a place where new family is created. Their own family and people that they come into relationship with and into it, but you know already and they don't yet. Father, you prepare that place for them.